In this video, I am going to explain about CSMA by CD, that is Carrier Sense Multiple Access with Collision Detection. It is a medium access method in Ethernet. It is also called as IEEE 802.3 standard. First, let us see what is the meaning of medium access method. For example, if station E wants to send data to station F, then station E should have access to the medium or channel in order to send the data. And if station H wants to send data to station G, then station H should have access to the medium or channel in order to send the data. To access the medium in Ethernet, the stations use CSMA by CD method. That is, Ethernet uses CSMA by CD method in order to access the medium. First, let us see what is the meaning of carrier sense. I'll explain carrier sense with the help of an example. If station E wants to send data to station F, before sending the data, station E should sense the carrier. That is, it should check the carrier. If the carrier is free, then it can send the data. Otherwise, it cannot send the data. Let us assume that at this particular time, E senses the carrier and it finds that the carrier is free. So, it will access the medium and it will send the data. In the next case, let us assume that at this particular time, E senses the carrier and it finds that the carrier is not free. So, it will not send the data. That is, in CSMA by CD method, any station can send the data at any time, but before sending the data, it should check the carrier. If the carrier is free, then it can send the data. Otherwise, it cannot send the data. But the problem with carrier sensing is any station cannot sense the entire carrier. Here, E can sense the carrier only at station E, F can sense the carrier only at station F, G can sense the carrier only at station G, H can sense the carrier only at station H. So, by sensing the carriers at stations E, F, G, H, those stations should identify whether the entire carrier is free or not, which is not possible. So, sometimes collisions may occur. For example, let us assume that E is your house and lines attached to E indicates roads. Then you can see the traffic on the road only to some extent, right? In the similar way, station E cannot check or sense the total carrier. For example, at time 4 o'clock, station E senses the carrier and it finds that the carrier is free. So it tries to send the data to station G. Now let us assume that at the same time, that is at 4 o'clock, station H also senses the carrier and it also finds that the carrier is free and it tries to send the data to station F. So now data is going from E to G and from H to F. After some time, collision occurs. Finally, data bits are corrupted. Now our data is of no use. In CSMA by CD method, after collision, a jamming signal will be sent to all the stations, which indicates collision in the channel. For example, let us assume that when E and H are received the jamming signal, at that particular point, if E and H are still transmitting the data, then these two stations can find that their data is involved in collision. But when E and H are received the jamming signal, at that particular point, if E completes its transmission and H is still transmitting its data, then H can find that its data is involved in collision because it is still transmitting the data. But E does not know whether its data is involved in collision or not, because at that particular point, that is when it received the jamming signal, like other stations F and G, it is also idle and it is not sending any data. To solve this problem, that is, in order to find whether E data is involved in collision or not, in CSMA by CD method, we need a particular frame size. If you use that frame size or data size, then all the stations in the network can correctly identify the collision. Then how to find the frame size? I'll explain how to find the frame size with the help of an example. Before that, we should know the meaning of two terms. Those are transmission time and propagation time. I'll explain transmission time and propagation time with the help of an example. There is a tap and there is a water can on the screen. The time taken to fill the water can is called the transmission time, and the time taken to carry the water can from one place to other place is called the propagation time. In the similar way, the time taken to transmit the data onto the ongoing link is called the transmission time. So, the time taken to transmit the data onto the ongoing link is called the transmission time, and the time taken to send the data from sender to the receiver is called the propagation time. If you observe, the time taken to fill the water can depends on the speed of the water flow and size of the water can. If the speed is high, then the time taken to fill the water can is less. In the similar way, transmission time depends on the bandwidth. Here, bandwidth is similar to flow of water. If bandwidth is high, then the transmission time is less. We know that if size of the water can is large, then the time taken to fill the water can is high. Similarly, transmission time depends on the length of the data. If length of the data is high, then transmission time is also high. Then we can define the time taken to fill the water can as size of the water can by speed of the water flow. Similarly, we can define the transmission time TT as length of the data by bandwidth. Now we will derive the actual formula. So transmission time equals to length of the data by bandwidth. So we will derive the actual formula now. In order to identify that whether its data is involved in collision or not, the sending station whose data is involved in collision should send the data till it receives the jamming signal of its data. In the best case, if collision occurs near station E, then a jamming signal will be sent to station E. When it receives the jamming signal, at that time, it's still transmitting the data. So, it identifies that its data is involved in collision. In the worst case, if the collision occurs near station H. So, when collision occurs near station H, then at that time, what happens is a jamming signal will be sent to all the stations. That is, a jamming signal will be sent to station E. Here, the time taken by the data to reach collision point is almost equal to the propagation delay, and the time taken by the jamming signal to reach the station E is also almost equal to the propagation delay. So, finally, it will take 2 into propagation time to reach jamming signal to station E. So, station E should send the data till this time. So, transmission time should be greater than or equals to 2 into propagation time. So, we know that transmission time equals to length of the data by bandwidth. So, length of the data by bandwidth should be greater than or equals to 2 into propagation time. So, finally, length of the data should be greater than or equals to 2 into propagation time into bandwidth. If you use this formula to set the length of the data, then the stations can identify the collision of its data. When collision is detected, then stations which are sending the data stops transmitting the data and wait for a random amount of time, then again starts transmitting the data. This is about CSMA by CD.